you see somebody, like, because Kevin has to be here at 5:15, and he's not as urgent as Oliver, but I mean, if there's some carpool or anybody who's coming over there, Vinnie Butner's, they all have to be here.
Okay.
Everyone's gotta be
I'll reach out to them. But yeah, there's, if I drive, there's no way I can, yeah, it's just not gonna, what time are you done by, 2:07?
Well, Oliver will be done at 5:40.
Does Kevin have quartet after?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'll do my best.
Okay. I mean, it's, since it's the dress rehearsal and the run-through, and it's the only time we're going to play everything with all the parts, it's...
I know.
It, yeah.
But I just can't be into places at once.
Right, but I'm going to say it's more important for him to be here than... You can drop him off first and then leave and take Savannah over. That,
I'm, and I'm going against the traffic, but...
Oh. When you get here, you need to take your violin out. It is not time for you to go play with Oliver.
Okay.
Okay.
I was also clipping my nails.
But then I found you playing with Oliver, and then I asked you to get your violin out 3 times, and you didn't until the 3rd time.
Mm-hmm. That means I'm sorry, Danielle. Next time I'll be prepared, right?
Yes, and I'm sorry, Danielle, and I'll be prepared next time. And I'm not tuning my bow.
That's a good plan too.
And I'm sorry for not being here on Monday. I had a homework issue and it won't happen again.
Okay.
And now with that we're on our really, I'm sorry. I can't come, we can't come at all next Thursday. I'm sorry. There's nothing I can do.
Okay.
I mean, I can't stick her in an Uber.
Right. I didn't know. I guess I need, these things are a lot.
I'm very sorry. There's just nothing I could do.
Okay. All right. All right, tonalization.
First the collet.
Sure. That one's fine. Is to see if we can pace it so that we gradually get louder and then gradually get quieter. And sometimes playing with the metronome helps. So let's try. And it's probably should go a little faster for you. Okay, see if we can do 4 beats per bow. 1, 2, 3, 4. Instead of 2, because it feels like there's a better sense of the whole. But if it's getting frustrating for any reason, just speed it up.
Okay.
All right, so colle, we're gonna keep our curved pinky. And then do the C6.
Yeah, I made a little cookie catcher. for my bow exercises.
Really, like this?
No, it's a kitty catcher.
Well, yeah, but I mean that kind of thing.
It has four sides.
Cool. You have to show me. Maybe we should make them in group class, and then we should all do our bow exercises like that. Mm. And maybe
you
we should make them say things about violin, like, what should we do first? Tonalization. Then what should we do? That would be fun. But you have to remind me how to make cootie catchers, because I used to know, I don't remember anymore.
Oh, I know. First, you have to get a piece of paper.
You can tell me later. Maybe you can teach the group class.
Okay.
All right, any questions that I can read music?
No, I don't have any questions.
Okay. Can I hear Hunter's chords? Which I think will add to the list. Okay, go for it. Okay? And don't rush.
Okay.
These are not running farmers. Or hunters, right? They're singing hunters.
Yeah, unless they're running to catch a bear.
Blueberries. Blueberries don't run away. Alright. Let's do waltz. When you do that, I'm gonna close the turn off the measuring. Uh-huh. You remember my favorite trick?
Oh.
It's really great. There's a couple of places where we could do the fancy fingers a little bit better so that we don't hear of any extra sounds. But at least you know where they all go, right?
I need to curve my fingers a little more.
So in some instances, yeah. Let's do it from the... We have to make sure the two curves enough that it gets over. And then, if Benny's got to move over when he's done, he's got to be ready to go again on the new string. The three. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Can you try that? Phrase A, extra curly first finger. You might need to eat more curly french fries. See? No extra sounds. Did you see that? Yes, you got it. Okay. So now, those are the two fancy finger spots that I want you to practice as fancy fingers. The next step is to get the dynamics to be even easier. Are you tired?
No.
No? Okay. Are you like, oh man, we have to talk about dynamics again?
No.
This is my favorite thing in music, dynamics. Well, that's not entirely true. I do like this thing called bariolage. That's a lot of fun too. So let's see if you can find dynamics. Right? Let's just go to the beginning. Can you hear me going up the stairs?
Yeah.
Yeah. You having a hard time getting comfortable?
Yeah.
What are you going up there?
I just.
You got
just too high up.
You got him?
Yeah.
Okay, go to the bottom stair. Beginning of each phrase in Bure.
They all start at the.
Mm-hmm.
So I forgot.
Keeping it steady while you're doing your dynamics. It's a sort of common disease, I like to say. That if you're trying to get loud, you try you quit faster too.
Yeah.
You slow down.
When
and you
I get
quiet.
Faster, I do faster bows.
Yeah, well, you can do faster bows, but then you have to use more bow. Does it make sense? So here, let's play.
Oopsie.
Let's do. Ah. Let's try it like this. From the one string to the other?
Yeah.
Should we can, that's what we can do right now?
Okay.
Make sure you keep breathing though. It's hard to play the violin and hold your breath.
Okay.
So. You play whatever speed is you like. Scale that's related to that?
G. A.
D.
D.
D. Starts with D. Have you tried that one? Yeah, you looked a little mystified. Did you? Do you? You get that? How the D minor scale is related to the F major? Okay.
I see. I said D the first time, then I said A.
Okay. You just looked like, I don't know. Then I said it and you looked at me like I was a little crazy. Which I am, but you know. Alright.
Not really.
A little. Okay, two grenadiers. I have a question. Did you get a chance to sing it?
Yeah.
Two Grenadiers is a little bit of a tricky piece because it has some funny rhythm and bowing, plus it is a new key. So I like to be extra picky about how I practice it. So let's go, can you get the music out?
Hope we have it.
We do.
We do?
Yeah, we have two books.
Oh, good.
No, that's the book one. The other one's book two.
Great.
Okay, put it on the stand. It's a special stand. It's unfortunate if that doesn't go much lower. It doesn't go any lower. Can you see okay?
Yeah.
Okay. So each one of these little phrases, you're going to learn one phrase at a time.
Okay.
And this is the only phrase that starts down bow. All the other phrases in the whole entire piece start up bow. What's that?
You don't have to mark this.
Well, it's nice to mark there. Okay. Oops. I'll get that one in the wrong place. Okay. Alright. So, I'm going to give you some things, some picky pointers for this piece, and I'm going to ask you to do it. Each phrase correct. And then repeat it 10 times correctly before you go to the next phrase. Okay? It'll help you not get overwhelmed and end up with things here.
Okay, put the three down.
Watch. See it?
Yep.
Let's do it. Little. Yeah. And next phrase. Concentration. So now that means you have to learn the whole thing. I just wrote learn all. But one phrase at a time.
Okay.
So what advice do you have for mothers who sometimes want to march over and touch their elbow and kind of keep that bow more straight?
Don't. I mean, because in a new piece, she's got too much to think about.
Well, yeah. But just in general, if I notice that, just leave it.
You can test the water. In the new stuff, leave it.
Yeah.
Something like Hunter's Chorus, you can probably think about it. It would be contingent on whether or not she was doing everything else that I have talked about.
It seems like it waxes and wanes. Like, I don't know, like 2 or 3 weeks ago, I was noticing the bow was straight a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, this week, it seems like it's not. And is there something that happens with, is that the way people are?
Well, all sorts of things can happen. We get into a growth spurt, we'll do it. If they put the violin up at a different angle, we'll do it. So today, at the beginning of her lesson, her sponge wasn't in the right place. So I noticed her violin was a little different.
Oh.
So
even just little things like that can.
Because really, the straight bow isn't about the bow, it's about the violin. It's about, because if you, I mean, or it's about both, it's because if your bow, you can do all this just a certain way, as soon as you do this, it's crooked.
Oh.
So that's part of it.
Is it also that some people just naturally have a straighter bow than others,
some
professionals, or, you know, is there a variation just in?
There's a little bit of a variation anyway. There's some professionals that don't have a perfectly straight bow, and there's various reasons for that. You know, I can think of one in particular, and he lets the bow go crooked as a strategy for changing lanes.
Okay.
And he does it on purpose.
So for Ella, making sure she's comfy and kind of tucked in is just a good...
Yeah, everything's balanced. That's the first step. And then if we're pushing the envelope in technique in another direction, mm-hmm. it will mess up the bow.
Okay.
So that's just normal. So things like the fast bows of Hunter's Chorus are going to throw the bow a little bit. The collet, if it's one free motion, like it was, she had a straight bow in the tonalization in the collet at the beginning of the lesson. But then in the context of Hunter's Chorus, I think she's trying to move her bow too fast to play loud, and really she needs to add more weight in that context of that piece.
Okay.
So what you could do, like her bow will probably get straighter if you say less bow, more weight. And then
okay.
that'll be...
Well, you know, sometimes I just want some guidance on what to just completely ignore, if that makes sense. And I'm tempted to just do that, but sometimes it's hard.
It is hard, especially when you know stuff. I mean, you have to be cognizant of what she has the capacity for in the moment, and whether or not she's getting the other stuff done. Because usually I will give her a lot. I'll give her a lot. She's picking things up, things like notes and stuff like that. She's picking that up pretty quickly. So that makes things a little bit easier for her. Mm. But the other thing you could do is layer it. Like if there's okay, we're going to do dynamics. Okay, now you got the dynamics. Now let's see if we can do dynamics with a straight bow. That kind of thing.
Okay.
So you can layer it in that way. I would try to not touch her because I want her to feel. It changes the kinesthetic experience of a straight bow because
mm-hmm.
you're not going to be performing with her.
Right.
That would be interesting. If all the parents came up and held their children's arm. The other thing is this arm is supposed to move when you play in the top bottom half of the bow. It goes moving. And so that's the other. So the tip is reaching out and then this has to be moved. So if you use that, it's like, I mean, you could do this where you just put your finger here and then she has to go back. But also review doing, that's something you can add in the review really easily.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's nice to have a focus point. If she knows the piece, there's no reason to play the piece except not to forget it. But to take some skill level, the next step.
Well, I mean, I do have a little bit of knowledge, but not enough, you know? And so sometimes I'm like, well, are you going too far back? Or,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? I don't know. But if you're not addressing it, I don't want to.
Yeah.
But every once in a while, I feel this urge to...
If it's crazy and she's just having an off day and just needs a little bit more centering around that, I think that that's fine.
Okay.
But I would do it in things like review.
Okay.
I can't imagine tonalization would come up in, or scale would come up. Don't do it in I Can Read Music.
Right.
Yeah. But things like waltz and... waltz, for sure, she can handle it. Hunter's Chorus after she warms up and does the spots.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes I go like that.
Yeah. And sometimes you just don't notice. It's just I don't want you to have a million things in your head. I just want to make sure whatever you're thinking about it, you can be successful at. That's really the crux of it, is whatever.
Okay.
So if you feel like she can handle more than what is on and you can add that and she can be successful with it, then it's great.
Okay.
Don't fall asleep until after we bow. Then you can snore. Thank you. And you can sing Witch's Dance, and this is exciting because Witch's Dance is on the Halloween concert.
Right, so the likelihood of us only being able to come here twice a week
mm-hmm.
and have Gretchen play in a quartet, is that actually a possibility?
I won't know until I know a quartet. So if we could get her lesson on the same day as quartet, but it depends on how early you can get here, things like that. Because
I would really love for her to be in a trio and for Gretchen to be a quartet, but I don't know how we could be here more than twice a week.
Right.
But, I mean, I don't know if you listen to it or have kids that she could play with, but I think it'd be great for her.
Yeah, I'm taking the survey sort of verbally this week, and then there'll be a form before the end of the week, and everybody will fill with it. And so then I'll know.
I mean, it just would be really fun.
Oh, yeah. No. Chamber music is one of my favorite things, and I sort of, from my childhood, wish I had done more. It's part of my ideas.
Will you go get it, Ella? Yeah, I mean...
I'll-